Okay, so now I'm going to move on to the, I guess, the second part of part six. If you haven't watched the first video in this assignment, which is the Camel Game Part 6A, it's just a little correction made to the code. It might not influence the game too much, but so just so that you're in the same pitch as I am, I recommend you go back to this video before continuing with the game. Let's fix something in the logic of the game, and then we can complete the game, or at least this part, in the next few minutes. So let's start to deliver some bad news to the player. In our next step, we're gonna give a message saying that your camel is getting tired if the camel's tiredness is above 5. Now, if you recall from the code, which I still have loaded up here from the last one, or maybe not, let me reload it. If you have not looked at the last video, just like I said, please do that so that you don't get lost in the in this video. So what I mean is, go to my REPLs, and I already saved the part camel p6. I hope that you can do that as well. Get a copy of 5, put it in 6, fix the code as mentioned in the previous video, and then move on to this one. So our instructions are to give the bad news about the camel getting tired. As you recall, every time that we run, especially when we're running and covering great distances, the tiredness of the camel increases by 1 every time, and sometimes more if the camel runs at a faster pace. So just like we have given the option, or not the option, but given the announcement that you are thirsty, we can do the same thing, announcing that the camel is getting tired. So if you recall here, and then part D, when we told the camel to take a nap, we reset the tiredness to 0. So camel tiredness is what we're going to be playing with. I'm going to scroll down a little bit here to before the thirst. Now, just to make sure that this makes sense, do we want to say that the camel is tired and then too tired, and then the game is done? So, well, I'm not really sure. Why don't we try to just go before the first if statement, before we check for the thirst. If it doesn't work, we'll move it down. So I'm gonna check if the camel tiredness is greater than 5, I think. Is that what we said? If it's above 5, then your camel is getting tired. If it's greater than 5, colon, next line, print parentheses, quote, backslash n, your camel is getting tired, period. And I guess if we are here already doing that, what is the next thing? Print your camel is dead if the camel's tiredness is above 8. Like the prior steps, print one or the other, but not both. So what we did in the fix of the thirst, we did the same thing basically. Well, your camel's getting tired, and then, or rather, you have that of thirst first to check. If that is the case, then you're done. Otherwise, you're only thirsty. But here we're saying that your camel's getting tired, and I don't want to say that your camel is dead right after that. So why don't I change the code to check? Let me see what the numbers are. I have 5 and 8. Let's check the greater one first. So if the camel tiredness is greater than 8, this is the fatal one. So I'm going to add some logic here. If the camel is greater than 8, then right in the next line, say print parentheses, quote, slash n, your camel is dead, exclamation point. Then go to the next part and tell it to check the camel tiredness again. If the camel tiredness is greater than 5, by this point, if the camel's not dead, we can still check it. Then print your slash n, your camel is getting tired, period. So I hope that that works. I already had printed that. If you typed it twice, I'm sorry. I'm going to delete one of the lines. So let's look at this logic. If camel tiredness is greater than 8, then print that your camel is dead. That's it. And the end, it should be the end of the game. So I'm missing here saying that done is equal to true with a capital T. So I should double check like I did in the last one. If the camel tiredness is greater than 5, but you're still going, and done is equal to false, then print that your camel's getting tired. Let's run this. And I'm going to stop while I'm going very fast. I'm going to stop for some drinks so that the camel is the one getting tired, but the user is not getting thirsty. So I can drink from the canteen with an A, and I can go ahead at full speed with C. So let's run at C until we get thirsty. Oh my, the camel died right away. And that's a problem with my logic, because I was running at full speed, forgetting that if we're running at full speed, we're actually putting way more miles than if we're going at a steady pace. So rather than going 1 + 1 + 1, we could be going as far as, or as fast as 3 + 3 + 3. So the camel gets tired really quick. Maybe something that can help here, and not only with the camel getting tired, but with you getting thirsty, is since we don't really have graphics yet, I'm going to maybe go into the messaging side. And when we start to say you are thirsty, for example, I'm going to add right after the N in the new line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines and a greater than to sort of make an arrow so that the user is told that they are thirsty. If you have that of thirst, well, that's it. You don't really need to bring too much attention. Maybe before that, when your camel's getting tired, also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and a greater than your camel's getting tired, just so that it brings it to our attention quicker. Let's run, and rather than running the poor camel at full speed, let's run him a little bit slower. So that is at moderate speed, B. So I'll say B, B, B. And now we get a message that I was able to see right away. You are thirsty. So let's go more at B, and let's drink some water. That is A. So now we have no thirst, but let's speed up a little bit. Let's go to C. And now I get the announcement, your camel's getting tired. So one thing that I can do, and we have already done this, is that we can stop for the night just to rest. So I'll press D. And now the camel yawns, takes a nap, and wakes refreshed. The drinks in the canteen are 2. The natives are right behind us though, so let's get going. C and C, and we're 20 miles ahead. And we move pretty quick after that, and the camel's getting tired and you are thirsty, so you got multiple things to do. I think that I would rest again for the night. That might be dangerous, but let's stop for the night. And then that's I'm still thirsty, so let's drink from the canteen and go ahead at a moderate speed. So now with the announcements being a little bit easier to see, there's still a sense of urgency, but there's more of a sense of play, so we can keep on moving forward. So now we have the bad news delivered. There are consequences to our actions, and next up, and let's see what the next thing that we got to do is, so we can wrap up this one video. We can move on to the next one. We have made the announcement, your camel is dead. However, if the natives have caught up, you know, because they're right behind you, if you're going to go slower to save your strength or to save your water, your enemy is going to be catching up, and that's part of the game. Let's see in the book what the directions say. If you're blah, 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 if the natives have caught up, print that they caught the player in the game. Else, if the natives are less than 15 miles behind, print the natives are getting close. And the way that we have been checking on the distance, we have been making an announcement alter the game, you are now 17 miles ahead of the natives, for example. So one thing that I'd like to do is this number, instead of having to figure it out every time, let's figure it out every time, but let's make it a simple variable that we can monitor. What I mean by that, I'm scrolling up to the top and I'm going to scroll down the code until I get to the first instance of it telling us how far ahead we are. So we have miles traveled and they have the native's distance, and you are now miles traveled minus native's distance. This is being figured out all the time, and what I mean by that is, since we are printing this all the time at this stage, why can't we figure it out at the beginning of the loop? So let's see how we can do that. Miles traveled minus native's distance is what we want. I'm going to select that just to copy it and have it handy. That is being messed with all the time. Miles traveled is equal to miles traveled plus a random amount, etc. Okay, well, I see why that needs to be calculated all the time. At the same time, though, I'm going to scroll all the way down. And we have all of these ifs, thens, and these are all still part of the loop. So inside of the loop, I'm going to create a new, well, at some point at the top, I'll put in enemies. I'm going to go back to the top, and I'm going to create a new variable that I can use in the program, and that's going to be called enemies. Just for now, it's going to be enemies is equal to 0. So that gets the program started with that variable. At the very bottom, this thing that I copied, mouse travel minus native's distance, we're going to say that enemies is equal to that amount. So that even though we're doing the math all the time, at the end of each loop, I can tell how far away the enemies are, and I can check real quick if I add an also within the loop, I'm still in the same distance from the edge as everything else in the loop. The loop, of course, begins with while, done is equal to false, do all this stuff, including what it's going to be doing now, which is figuring out that enemies are so far away, and tell it to do us a favor and for now print what enemies is. And I can put in enemies, comma, miles away. So let's see if that runs. So I'll run it and I'll say go forward fast. So you're now 29 miles ahead of the natives, and the math is done at the bottom and it shows us 2. If I go at a slower pace, I will do a B at a moderate pace, and I'm 24 miles away. We're now 24 miles away from the natives, so that's good. I'll do the same thing again and again. I'm thirsty, I don't want to die here, but I just want to check that this 23 miles ahead of the natives is being repeated 23 miles away. So now I have, outside of the loop, a way to check what that number is. So I can say something like, right here where it's telling us this message already, enemies are so far miles away, I'm going to say that if enemies is less than 20, well, actually that's so 15, I think that the book said 15. If the natives are less than 15 miles away, say the natives are getting close. So if enemies is less than 15, colon, go to the next line, print, I'll delete everything but enemies, so that I can say then the enemies are getting close. I guess I didn't need enemies, the variable there. So if the enemies are closer than 15, then print this message, the enemies are getting close. Of course, what I've been noticing though is that in the game, we're giving the enemies a lot of slack, so they're not really getting too close to us. We're giving advantage to the player. How can we change that? I'm going to scroll up and make sure that you make some of these changes. The mouse travel, I mean, they're all random. They can go up to 13 miles. So that's actually, that's pretty big. I'm gonna reduce that between 5 and 13 to go 5 and 10 to say that even though we're moving at moderate speed, that we're not moving so fast. And I'll take away from 15 to 12 in this line. In C, when we move really fast, we go from 10 to 21. Just, I mean, we really do want to move fast, but I'll change that instead of 21, 18. And camel tiredness, that'll remain the same. And the distance, I'll leave it the same so that the natives actually move at about the same speed. So I guess then where I change this, the native distance, I don't want to handicap them. So I'll put this back at 15. So on my choice B, mouse travel, it's equal to mouse travel plus random ran range between 5 and 10. But as far as the native distance, that'll be between 7 and 15. That'll stay the same way. And then mouse travel is equal to mouse travel. I'm on choice C. Random range 10 to 18, which is less than before, the native distance will keep the same. And on E, it's just a status check, so that doesn't do much. And a happy camel comment, this D, camel tiredness is 8. Okay, so let's stop this and run again and see if we get any different results. I'm gonna see if I tell it to go fast. C, 16 miles away from the natives. I'll go at B, and actually now I'm 11 miles ahead of the natives. Your thirst is now at 2, but the enemies are getting close. So that worked. Let me go fast again, and now I'm 18 miles away. So this seems to be a little bit more competitive, and I like this a little bit better. Let's see what else we can do so I can finish this part of the video. If the natives are caught up, print that they have caught up the player and end the game. So when have the natives caught up? Let's see. If I just, I'm gonna stop and rest for the night. What is that? That is, stop for the night is D. So the natives are 4 miles behind us. I'm gonna go at moderate speed. And now the enemies are getting close, but how close are they? I can't tell. I'm minus 3 miles ahead of the natives, so actually they have caught up. What I want is, so this distance, the enemies variable that I created is now at a negative space, so I can say then that if in the code, if enemies are less than 15, then the enemies are getting close. I want to say that if the enemies are at 0 or less, then they have caught up with us. So I can add before the enemies check at 15, if enemies is less than or equal to 0, colon, print the enemies caught you. You lose. You lose. And then it checks if the enemies are less than 15. So we have the same problem as before. Well, print the enemies have caught you, you lose, and then we stop the game. Done is gonna be equal to true in the line right after that one. And just like we did before, then we're gonna double check if enemies is less than 15, but the game is still going, and done is false, capital F, then say that the enemies are getting close, but don't end the game. Okay, so this said the enemies are getting close because that's important information. I'm also going to add the arrow to show me that something is happening. Stop this and run again. And I'm gonna say, okay, let's go fast. 18 miles ahead. I'll go at moderate speed with B. You are now 15 miles ahead of the natives, B. So they're getting closer, and we get an announcement that the enemies are getting close. Let's go slow still here. The enemies are getting close. Well, I don't know how close they are, but I'm getting thirsty, so I'm gonna drink from the canteen with A. The camel's getting tired, so we should stop for the night. D. They are 3 miles behind us, so they're getting close, and the computer is telling me so, but let's go ahead and go slow, see how far ahead they catch up. B. And you are now minus 4 miles ahead of the natives. Your thirst is now at 1, but the enemy's caught you and you lose. So we have now generated an algorithm that will determine that the enemies have caught up with us. And there's some cleanup that we gotta do with the way that that's displayed, but I'll figure that out in the next steps. Right now, I think that we figured out what we needed to in steps 19, 20, 21, and 22. The natives have caught up, and that they have caught up the player in the game. Else, if the natives are less than 50 miles ahead, please print the natives are getting close. So we're doing fine. I think that probably the next video will complete the game.